Now we're going to see the signs and symptoms of hypothyroidism. In hypothyroidism, we have decreased T4 and T3. So everything of the effects that we saw in the previous video will be decreased, and these will be the signs and symptoms. So first, the metabolic rate will be decreased. We will have decrease in the natrium potassium ATPase. So increasing the metabolic demand, so the patient will have weight gain. Also, there is a inability to excrete water, so there is water retention that leads to hyponatremia. In the cardiovascular effect, remember that the thyroid hormone increases the affinity and the numbers of beta adrenergic receptors, so increases the heart rate, contractility, stroke volume, cardiac output. Because we have decreased T4, the cardiac output will be decreased, and so the patient will have dyspnea in exertion. Usually at rest is normal, but in exertion certainly we have dyspnea. And bradycardia. You have bradycardia. In the musculoskeletal system, would be tunnel carpal syndrome, mixed edema. The mixed edema is due to the glycosaminoglycans that pull the water due osmosis, and the pulling of the water leads to swallowing. The swallowing of the tissue. This will present as a lump in the muscle after striking with a hand. So this will be the mixed edema. Also, the patient will have in psychiatric symptoms depressed mood. Remember that the T4 and T3 produces anxiety when there is excess. So here the patient will have a depressed mood. In the GI tract, the patient will have constipation and decreased appetite. The patient will be cold intolerance, and we have a lot of cold. The skin findings will be sometimes the patient will have a ecteric appearance due to, remember that T4 and T3 converts the carotene to vitamin A. If we have decrease of this conversion, we have increased carotene, and so the skin turns yellow. Also, in the hair, we have brittle hair. Also, some abnormalities in the nails, in the fingers, etc. Also, would be muscular myopathy. Again, proximal myopathy. The same way as or similar to hyperthyroidism, the important issue here is that here the creatinine kinase will be elevated, and in the hyperthyroidism the creatinine kinase is low. We will have hypercholesterolemia due to decrease in the clearance of cholesterol. The decrease in clearance is decrease in the LDL receptor expression. So the cells cannot take cholesterol, and so the patient has hypercholesterolemia.